We have today with us Sanjay, Vikas and Karan from the Mercy India team. These three trio are doing a real great job on the travel side for India. So why don't you tell us something more about you and your company?
Yeah, so we started mercyindia.com about 2 years back. We are all friends from, we have worked together in past. Sanjay was in my college. We used to stay in the same hostel. Karan, we used to work in together in at Trilogy on the same product. So after working for quite some time in corporate environment, we realized that we are not satisfied with our day-to-day jobs. We wanted to do something more challenging, more exciting. So after some brainstorming, we came up with the idea of travel domain, and that's how we started on this.
Why especially the travel domain? Like anything specific you had interest in that or anything?
Yeah, me and Vikas were having a discussion once when he came in, and we just discussed something on travel and other domains. Then I have been like an avid traveler myself. I have lots of interest in traveling around, and I've been to lots of places in India. So we decided upon that, okay, this is something that we would want to pursue, because this is like a hobby that we already have and a passion that we would want to convert into work. And the other thing was that we wanted, as a traveler, we felt that there were certain gaps when we were trying to do travel planning. And you know, every time I have to travel, when I wanted to travel, I had certain issues that I had to search every time and do things, in which I thought that there was some gap in the Indian industry. So being techies, we thought that we could fill that gap, and that is how we started upon with Mercy India.
So tell us about Mercy India, like what exactly you guys do and what is the proposition there?
Yeah, so what Mercy India is, basically your travel companion. So what we are trying to do is that since we have, every time when we have to travel, and we focus on leisure travel. So every time you have to travel to a place, you don't know, first of all, you don't know which place you would want to go to. If you know which place, then you would want to, you don't get enough information on the net on why you should visit that place, what is it that you should see there. And then there are all these logistics and stuff that again comes as a part of a problem with it. So we want to fill in that gap. So what we do is that we are identifying the gaps which are currently there. Like the major gap that we see is information. We don't see reliable information for tourist places in India. So what we did was that we found, collected all the information. So what we as Mercy India primarily does is we provide reliable information about various tourist places in India.
So how do you collect this information? Like you did it on your own, or you have tied up with few people to provide this?
Yes, so we collected via multiple ways. There is we have traveled ourselves to lots of places, so we have first-hand experience of them, so we collected that. Then there are various writers who have traveled to those places and they see it, so that way also we collect information. Then other information sources are like travel blogs and pictures that we see over the internet by real travelers.
So what is your unique proposition here, Sanjay?
When I am not sure where to start from, I would want to first come to Mercy India. There I would want to find, okay, these are the places I can go. And then I would want to plan it. We would have that planning done. We can, you know, I would send that stuff to my friend and whoever I want to travel with. And finally, when it is done, then at that point, I would want to go for ticketing. So we are a start point for travel thing, and that's what our focus is.
Do you have a travel planner also or something, or how does it work?
We have a planner which is in beta. So right now, we focus more on information at this point of time. but we are coming up with planning features.
So what kind of challenges have you faced till now, and like how did you guys have come across those challenges?
So initially when we started, we wanted to build very good content on our site, a very reliable content. So that was one of the missing features which we identified when we started building Must See India. So we identify about 500 plus destinations in India, and we really struggled to get the right content for those destinations, like what are the major tourist attractions there, what is the best weather to go there, and it was so hard to collect all this information, the weather information, from all the various sources, that it took a lot of energy, a lot of effort and a lot of time, and it over multiple iterations of filtering out, we have reached the stage where we have very reliable content on where to go, when to go. So if somebody is looking to go around Pune in the month of March, then we can actually tell him what are the places around Pune to go in the month of March. So gathering all the quality content was one of the main challenges we have faced so far.
How about your financial challenges, Karan?
So financial challenges are also there because we three are bootstrapped. So the way we have managed is that we have used our own personal savings, and we have convinced some of our friends that this idea is really wonderful, and they are also convinced on our efforts, they are convinced with our skill, so they have also provided some of the finances. So right now we are pretty stable financially, as in we are not looking for funding immediately, and again, we Must See India is now progressing towards making decent amount of money, so that we are expecting to break even in a couple of months. So we have our revenues also growing from the ad space and from the bookings which we provide through our various partners. So finances is always a challenge for a startup, and I think it should be very well planned. The mistake we made in planning our finances was like we only estimated for about a year or so, but it has taken us more than a year to break even. So any entrepreneur should at least plan his finances very well, and should double his estimate when he's estimating how much money he needs to start up.
So what really keeps you guys motivated, and what is your feeling right now? So you were more happy in the job, or you are more happy now, and what would you suggest to the budding entrepreneurs?
Absolutely. We are extremely happy with the current going of Must See India. And the self-satisfaction that startup gives you, I mean, you don't get that in a regular job. I mean, you are your own boss, and you get to do things that you want to do. You don't have any limitations of a big corporate where you want to do something, but there are rules, there are processes that you cannot go beyond a certain level. And that glass ceiling is not there in your own startup.
Also, you get to create things which would be really put to use for public use.
Absolutely.
You can
absolutely
see that working.
You get a chance to make a difference to this world. So there are lots of things which are not in the ideal state. There are things which are wanting to be improved, and you get a chance to make a real difference and help out thousands of users.
So what would you suggest to the budding entrepreneurs?
Anything? Persistence is very important. A startup life is hard, and it's very easy to give up after some failures. Failures are part of a startup life. You try out something, try out fast, and let it fail fast, and then move on to more things.
You were saying that you are on the verge of break even. So going forward, are you really looking at VC funding 2 years down the line for a major or inorganic expansion or something?
I think we'll avoid the funding as much as possible. And if we continue to maintain the current growth rate, we should break even in about 3 months' time. So we are very close to achieving that, and we'll avoid any external funding.
Great. So thanks a lot. I would really thank Sanjay, Vikas and Karan, the team at eLagan. Wishes you all the best.